Apple Thunderbolt Display is a beautifully made, high-quality screen with gorgeous and accurate colour reproduction. It even offers greater convenience as the single Thunderbolt connection not only carries the display signal, but also USB, Gigabit Ethernet and FireWire 800, which turns it into a docking station for your notebook. How does it do this? Thunderbolt is basically a combination of PCI Express, like the slots inside your PC, multiplexed with DisplayPort for transmitting graphics information. The Apple monitor demuxes the two signals, separating the DisplayPort video signal from the PCI Express data. You can then think of the USB, Ethernet and FireWire ports on the monitor as kind of like being PCI cards on your PC, but at the end of a very long extension cable so that they can sit inside the monitor. It's all very clever. And this is why you can't plug the mini DisplayPort output of your computer into a Thunderbolt monitor, even though the connector looks the same. The monitor is expecting that multiplex stream of DisplayPort and PCI Express data and doesn't know what to do with the pure DisplayPort signal that you're sending it. And this is also why there's no simple adapter cable to get around the problem either. Some PC motherboards do have a Thunderbolt output, but they mix in the DisplayPort signal from the onboard graphics. Their Thunderbolt chip knows nothing of your fancy Nvidia or AMD add-in card, which expects to send their output via the sockets on their backplates. Other manufacturers have taken a different approach, one of whom is Asus via their add-in ThunderboltEX II card, which supports add-in GPUs. So let's take a look. Asus sell Thunderbolt expansion cards for PCs in both single-port and dual-port varieties for around $70 and $100 respectively. Unfortunately, you can't just throw one into any PC, even if it has an Asus motherboard. Asus lists several of their own boards on the compatibility list for the card, but it's horribly out of date, and owners of later motherboards may not realise that the card actually works perfectly in their systems as well. If your motherboard has a Thunderbolt header, like my Sabertooth X99, you're all set. You'll also need a spare PCI Express slot that provides at least PCI Express 2.0x4 speeds. Asus provides a cable that runs from the expansion card to the motherboard header, which on mine is right at the bottom. But the cable itself looks a bit clunky, it's also ugly and difficult to hide. You will need to connect the output from your DisplayPort graphics card into the DisplayPort in on the Thunderbolt card, so that it can multiplex that signal with the PCI Express from your motherboard. But don't do it yet, as we need to install the drivers first. Instead, power on your system and enter the BIOS. Under Advanced, make sure Thunderbolt is enabled and the appropriate PCI slot selected. I'd suggest you flash your motherboard with the latest firmware, as this seems to solve a lot of the issues that other people have experienced. Then boot up into Windows and install the latest drivers from the Asus website. My card wasn't actually detected by Windows until I did this. I then plugged the Thunderbolt monitor into the expansion card via a Thunderbolt cable and it was immediately detected. I then unplugged my 980 Ti from the monitor and plugged it into the Thunderbolt card via the loopback cable that's provided in the box. And that was it. The monitor was now running via Thunderbolt from the 980 Ti. Given that Apple charge $50 for a lot of their display adapters, spending $70 on this expansion card to act as a kind of adapter for my 980 Ti isn't actually too bad. Especially as I can now also use Thunderbolt devices on my PC as well. So it's kind of a good value from that perspective.
If you found this review helpful, let me know by hitting the like button and dropping me a comment. And check out some of my other reviews and how-tos. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any future videos.